So I've got Sulagna, who is Sulagna Chatterjee. She's the writer, you know, and it's really beautifully done, right? Like, she loves me. She loves me a lot. She loves me not, which is what we're used to hearing so much. And what was it like? Let's go back to the very start. Did you from the onset know ki mujhe Bollywood mein jana hai, banana hai, ya how did that journey happen for you?
Well, kahani bahut hi filmy hai mere life ki tarah, and like everything I create. Frankly, shuruaat hui thi at the age of 8, as dramatic as it sounds. Dadi ke saath baith ke kasauti zindagi ki dekhti thi, and I would see concept Ekta Kapoor, and I had zero clue sitting in Calcutta watching all those K-serials. I had zero clue ki bhai kaun hai Ekta Kapoor, pata nahi. But seeing the over-dramatic, super over-the-top kind of drama and seeing that at the end of the day, the protagonist goes through everything and comes out stronger wali jo feeling thi, I just would see all of that and be like, I don't know who the hell this woman is, but I want to be that. Cut to 2008, we shifted to Bombay from Calcutta, and that's when the journey actually began. Because, you know, it was very funny that malls mein se ghoomte phirte actors dikh jate the, and it should be like, oh my god, they actually exist. Ye log grocery shopping karte hai. What the hell? Like, they are beautiful. And I would have these like child actors even in school and college and all of that. But tab tak matlab full family commerce background ki hai, as Bengali as it can get. And I used to feel like, okay, this is not where I belong. 11th, 12th will be commerce kar liya, but then I was like, nahi bhai, matlab full life aise na ho payega humse. So Mithibai mein thi, and Mithibai is known for all its star alumni people. And I was a part of these college fests and all of that stuff. And that's where I started like feeling that this is where I belong. I love this madness. I love all of this thing of these things. And haan, then ek ek karke cheeze hoti gayi. College chalu hua, internships hoti gayi. Then after I graduated, I worked with Star Plus for a while, and that's when the dream actually came true. Like, it was heavenly, and I would go on the sets. And though I was in the PR team of Star and not the content team, but going to the set, seeing people run around with scripts, with walkie talkies, and all of that stuff, just made me feel like, oh my god, this is how it's created. Like, this is where I belong. So that's how it started, from an associate writer in a small time, really nice company called Short Circuit, having the best bosses throughout who constantly encouraged me. To then, obviously, like, it was the funniest thing that jo sapna 8 saal ki umar mein dekha tha ki Ekta Kapoor pata nahi kaun hai par ye banna hai. The first fiction show I ever did was this show called Code M, which was for Alt Balaji, and I was like, oh my god. Abhi us safar ko shuru hue almost 2 saal ho gaye, from an associate writer to finally doing my own thing, seeing my name solo credit pe. So it's been quite a journey.
Wow. I mean, so much shiddat se tumhe paane ki koshish ki hai to making it happen. For everyone who's watching who wants to do this, just a cursory question. Zaruri hai ki tumhe padho ya koi aisa course karo ki it does not matter what your background or education is.
It doesn't really matter. I mean, ye question na maine khud ko bhi bahut saalon tak pucha hai ki bhai, should I go to film school, should I not? Pehle to ek baat ye hai ki India mein zyada acche film schools hai nahi. Aur dusri baat ye hai ki, I mean, unlike technical courses like say direction or editing or cinematography, not even direction actually, I mean, direction aapko koi sikha nahi sakta, wo aapki nazar hoti hai. Similarly, writing aapko koi sikha nahi sakta. The stories that come to you from your experiences, come to you from your life, come to you from the people you talk to, the world that you see. Though what film school really helps you in doing, or any course like for that matter, help like films like that helps you in doing, is ki aapko ek डिसिप्लिन सिखा देता है, आपको एक टेक्निकलिटी सिखा देता है जो भी बहुत जरूरी होता है. बट उसके बाद उन टेक्निकलिटीज को ब्रेक करना, लाइक द मोमेंट यू नो द रूल्स, यू नो हाउ टू आल्सो ब्रेक देम. तो फिल्म स्कूल्स रियली इंस्टिल्स अ सेंस ऑफ डिसिप्लिन फॉर श्योर. लाइक माई गर्लफ्रेंड हैज बीन टू FTII, तो उसका अलग ही नजरिया है चीजों को देखने का, मेरा अलग ही नजरिया है चीजों को देखने का. बट at the end of the day, both of us are storytellers, and at the end of the day, both of us just want to tell good stories. So, aap film school jaye na jaye, jo sabse zyada important hota hai ki aap duniya ko observe karo. Even if you go to like an international film school, but you can't see beyond yourself, I don't think you can write good stories. You need to constantly keep learning, unlearning, relearning, meet different people, have different experiences, do stupid things, make bad decisions. I think making bad decisions makes you a really good writer.
Yeah. So underrated. Making bad decisions.
Make screw-ups. That's the first rule.
Okay. So ye hui aapki kahani. Is kahani ki kahani kahan shuru hui? Is I mean, from what I hear, it's a task to get these production houses or get like the OTT platforms to sign up. Were you a part of that struggle, or was it the production house taking care of it? For all of us who have no idea how any of this works, what was it like?
I think ye journey bahut hi alag si thi. Matlab, it came to me out of the blue. So like just a bit of context. 2020 ki shuruaat mein, I decided that bhai, 2 saal naukri kar li. बहुत एसोसिएट असिस्टेंट वाला काम कर लिया, बहुत सीख लिया जितना था मतलब, पर अभी टाइम हो गया कि भाई इंडिपेंडेंटली लिखना है मुझको. तो जनवरी 2020 में फुल्ली आत्मनिर्भर, आई वाज लाइक भाई अभी तो मैं लिखेगा कहानी लिख गया. तो जनवरी 2020 में आई क्विट माय जॉब, आई वेंट फॉर अ सोलो ट्रिप, फाउंड माय सेल्फ, डिस्कवर्ड माय सेल्फ एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट. फिर सोचा कि चलो भाई अब तो पिच करना स्टार्ट करेंगे खुद को एज एन इंडिपेंडेंट यंग राइटर. एंड मार्च में कोविड हैपेंड एंड आई वाज लाइक तेरी ये तो थोड़ा सा चैलेंज हो गया. तो फॉर 2-3 months ऑलमोस्ट ऑफ सर्च आई हैड जीरो वर्क एट ऑल एंड आई वाज लुकिंग फॉर वर्क, आई वाज डूइंग माय ओन थिंग्स. बट थैंकफुली मेरी प्रिविलेज है कि मुझे रेंट नहीं भरना होता मुंबई जैसे शहर में, माँ बाप की कृपा है वैसे. तो इट वॉज अ जर्नी, इट वॉज अ स्ट्रगल ऑल्सो दैट पहले मतलब स्टार्ट करते ही ऑब्स्टेकल मतलब एटलीस्ट लेवल 1 का ऑब्स्टेकल आए ना, लेवल 10 का ऑब्स्टेकल all of a sudden aa gaya. But then thankfully the first story, the first show that I got was for Dice Media called First Season 3, which was also a queer story. And then weirdly 2-3 weeks later, there's this writer called Pobali Chaudhary who's written Rock On and who's written Kai Poche, and she's fantastic. She and I had never really spoken as such. She messaged me, and as you know, मैं तो बहुत ही वोकल हूँ अपने सेक्सुअलिटी को लेके, मतलब मेरा बस चले तो मतलब टेरेस पे चीख चीख के
सब को लेके लगना. ट्विटर पे बहुत ज़्यादा वोकल है सब चीज को लेके,
एवरीथिंग सब इंक्लूडिंग माय रिलेशनशिप
एवरीथिंग.
Pobali messaged me one day and she was like, hey, would you be interested in writing a same sex love story? And I was like, ओते ये कहाँ से. And I was like, yeah, sure, why not? Like, yeah. So she was like, okay, I'll pass on your number to the like concerned person and then you can speak to them. And I was like, chalo ji, theek hai. So then I got a call a few days later from Sumalata from Mutant Films and Satish Rajkasireddy from Mutant, who was heading the development for the show. And they gave me the brief. They were like, hi, we need like a 20-minute or young love, teenage or young adult kind of a space, may a story. So think about it and like, let us know whatever you have. Send us something by Friday. Ab din tha ye Tuesday ya Monday ka. Aur unko, mujhe unko, unhone bola ki Friday tak kuch ek pager bhej do. And I was like, chalo ji, theek hai. Jo mere liye mushkil hai nahi. Matlab, ek do pager aapka basic idea agar commission ho jata hai, then it's not difficult. Ab baat yu hui ki Friday ko bhejna tha. Aur Wednesday ko, I had like the horriblest anxiety situation where I couldn't get out of bed. I was in that bad a position that I literally texted Sumlata saying that, listen, I don't think I'll be able to do this because I'm in a very bad space. And I was like, chalo ji, gaya haath se project, but kya hi kare? And because I think in the lockdown, I also realized that, bro, mental health comes first at all given points in time. Kaam hota rahega. So then Satish ka message aaya unko and unhone mujhe forward kiya ki like Sulagna ko bolo ek do din aur le le aaram se, I want to read her story. And I was like, okay. So by Sunday night I sent them 2 concepts, me and this little girl who is a symbiosis student, her name is Shweta Ranganathan. She is my little baby basically, so a very good friend of mine. She's somebody I knew from Twitter. She and I, we basically sat together and cracked something as like, you know, I told her the basic concepts that I had and she was the one who added, jo aap logon ne agar show mein dekha hoga, plan gave away. That was Shweta's idea basically to use that amazing term altogether. So hum logon ne bheja unko 2-pager level and I was really excited. I was like, dude, ye acha to lag raha hai. And this story, frankly, in the most cliched writer trope, ye idea mujhe aaya sapne mein. Because literally.
And you remember your dreams. Wow.
Yeah, it was like this. So 2 saal se jab se main likh rahi hu tab se main raat ko apne baju mein ek diary rakh ke soti hu ki suppose aisa kuch idea aa gaya, kabhi pura diary khali tha life mein aur kuch usme nahi dala gaya tha. This one day, because this idea was constantly in my head, I was just like, bro, at like 2-2:30 at night I suddenly wake up and I'm like, oh my god, a closeted queer girl trying to give her crush hints without actually giving her hints. Now that is something all of us have gone through, I think so. So next day I wrote it all out and sent it out. I was like, ab bhagwan bharose, abhi pata nahi jo hoga dekha jayega. And I kind of knew ki bhai 20 minute aur mang rahe hai, matlab Netflix ya Prime ke liye hi hoga, because anthologies aajkal wahi bana rahe hai. And tabhi bas naya naya, matlab the entire love stories, ghost stories, all of the stuff had happened recently. So I know ki haan bhai, yehi chal raha hai abhi. Do hafte tak, nothing happened. Zero, like complete radio silence. And I was like, chalo ji, theek hai, apni side se bhej to diya. Now at least mutant people will know that a writer like Sulagna exists. Yes. Matlab, maine bhi kya socha tha ki kyun ho jayega first bar mein aise try karte. Full on aisa zone. Then I remember this one day, I was sitting for lunch. I had my phone next to me and I was eating. And all of a sudden, I get this Gmail pop-up. And it's a message from, it's a mail from Satish saying that, congratulations, Sulagna, your story has been approved by Netflix. And I was like, I don't think I can ever forget that emotion. I just started crying. I literally started bawling like a child. I think wo jo unreal wali feeling thi ki this can't be real, this can't be happening, what the actual hell? Wo feeling, I think till the time maine apna naam credit pe dekha nahi, tab tak wo wali feeling thi ki nahi ho raha hai, matlab ye sach nahi hai, matlab abhi koi utha dega, abhi koi chutki kaat dega, and like I will wake up and this would just have been like a dream. That's how it happened. And it was a beautiful journey all throughout, like from sitting in front of the blank page on final draft to writing interior, you know, Muskan's house, from the first draft to the final production draft. Like Danish came on board in September as and he made it so much more visual. He made it so much more colorful altogether. It was wonderful working with him. Yeah, the show, the episode got shot in December and I was in Calcutta around then. My mom had just been diagnosed with cancer. Unka treatment chal raha tha. So all around that, this was the one thing that kind of kept me going, kept me being like, okay, there is something good that is happening. There is something like my words will be reflected on screen. So fati padi thi bahut gandi wali, because I was like, itne saalon se chilla chilla ke bol rahi hu, queer people telling queer people stories, abhi main likh rahi hu, abhi isme screw up kar diya to bhai lag jani hai meri. Yeah, the entirety of this 1 year, like it's 27th July today, right? Coincidentally, today was the day last year that the show, that I got that mail that Netflix had approved my story. So bhai kya saal raha hai, bhai saal.
Wow, just, I think this in itself can be a story. You're so vocal about mental health, about your relationship and your orientation, all of that, right? I want to understand, in a world where everything is so perfectly crafted, where PR teams dictate every single fraction of a second, tumhe kya karna chahiye? How do you keep it so real? And does Bollywood really have space for that? Does Bollywood understand mental health and, you know, different orientations? Do they have their empathy?
पहले तो अच्छी बात है पीआर टीम है नहीं मेरी. मेरे दोस्त थी, माय बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स अक्षत एंड प्रिया एंड माय गर्लफ्रेंड राधिका, दे आर द वंस हु आर जस्ट लाइक, सूला नहीं, अब से शिट पोस्टिंग नहीं करने का, अब तो चुपचाप ठीक से लिख. एंड आई एम लाइक, अरे यार, सो एवरी टाइम समबडी कूल फॉलोज मी ऑन ट्विटर, आई एम जस्ट लाइक, चलो दो दिन तक मैं कुछ शिट पोस्ट नहीं करेगा, मैं सिर्फ प्रोफेशनल बातें करेगा. एंड देन आई एम जस्ट लाइक, ओह माय गॉड, माय गर्लफ्रेंड इज सो ब्यूटीफुल. या सो ट्राई करती हूँ, नहीं हो पाएगा मुझसे, आई डोंट थिंक सो, फिर भी बहुत कोशिश करती हूँ. Does Bollywood understand mental health? Does Bollywood have space for conversations like this? I think shuruaat ho rahi hai dheere dheere, bahut baby steps hai. Sadly ye bhi ho raha hai ki every step that we are taking ahead, we are also taking two steps back. Mentality badalne mein bahut time lagega. Jo hustle culture hai hamara, jo constantly to be, as you said, like perfectly articulate about everything, is actually slightly problematic, because there is no space to grow in such situations.
Or be real. Where's real?
Or be real. Say that, bro, I don't know enough about this to have an opinion, but I am educating myself. I think what has changed even on social media in the past few years is that aajkal dialogues kam hote hai, attacks zyada hote hai. So, mujhe bhi bahut trolling milti hai kabhi kabhi. There have been times where I also have, like in the past, because I joined Twitter when I was 16-17, this is like 2013, tab bahut alag thi ye space. To aajkal kabhi kabhi ho jate hai ki bhai koi to trolls aake koi to purane cheeze khod ke nikalenge, and I'm like, okay, I acknowledge that my opinions might have not been as nuanced as they are now, and even now the opinions I have, maybe 5 years down the line I will have changed those opinions. And in those times, if you bring up stuff from then, I will acknowledge and be like, okay, I apologize, or I was a different person. I think it's a constant thing of growth. It's a constant journey altogether, you know. Aajkal fir bhi main try karti hu thoda sa zyada nuanced hone ka. The problem is that we put Bollywood or people associated with the entertainment industry on such a high pedestal that even from them there is a certain expectation to behave a certain way. Wo soch badalni hai, but wo bhi matlab abhi time to lagega for sure hone mein. Kyunki sab itna perfectly packaged hota hai ki agar koi usse nikalne ki koshish kare bhi, duniya tumko khinch ke wapas leke aayegi ki nahi 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 mat karo, kaam nahi milne wala.
Yeah.
Because a friend of mine with very good intentions actually told me, and I also understand that. Like, I completely also understand where she's coming from. She was like, listen, don't talk about mental health so much on your main, because we know where you're coming from. And professional people see that they don't have the same kind of understanding of anxiety or depression or bipolarity or any of that. They'd just be like, oh my God, okay, she might not be able to meet deadlines, or she's just too preoccupied with like other things. Would she really be able to do this? So it's one step at a time, I think. So, dheere dheere jeet hogi hamari, aur real reality ki.
So that brings me to the next one. How did you manage to keep it so real? Okay, spoiler alert. For me, 2-3 things stood out. Like, it just hit me because I was like, oh my God, yeah. When they're stuck in traffic, first of all, it's so meta. Because they're like, Bollywood ye kabhi nahi dikhayega. But sach to yehi hai. Ki jo bhi plan banao, tumhe traffic mein fasna hi hai. How did you keep it so real? And also, you know, the way Tarasha on the face of it seems like this very sorted, you know, like person who has it all together, such an achiever, award winner. But one line from somebody can throw her off. And those are facts. How did you keep it so real?
I think both, you know, log kehte hain ki jab aap likhna start karte ho, you mainly get all your, like, everything from your surroundings, from the shared experiences, from your own experiences, right? So I have seen people, including myself, I've been dealing with anxiety for the past 4 years. So almost every day is a struggle. There are days which are great, there are days which are horrible. There are days where, like yesterday, I had an anxiety attack so bad, but I still finished a 30-pager screenplay with dialogues in 10 hours. So achievement, like what I really wanted to show was, it doesn't matter how sorted you seem from the outside. And everybody strives for that sortedness, you know, like even in therapy, I remember I keep telling my therapist that, oh, I want to be mature and sorted. And she was like, where is that coming from? It comes from a lot of trauma, because you want to project a certain version of yourself. Every, you know, millennial or every Gen Y person, they've seen, like, everything about our life is all about social media, about the way we project ourselves, about the idea of perfection, right? I really wanted to break that. And I really wanted to show that her anxiety doesn't define her at all. Nor does her achievements invalidate the fact that she can have mental health issues as well. Both of the things can coexist. Not just one, like one part of your or one facet of your personality or your mental health doesn't define you. How normal it is to have anxiety. It is just like anything else, and it needs to be talked about like that. Because aajkal, I mean, in my closest circuit, I think all of us are going to therapy. That is the norm. If you don't get to therapy, that's a problem, because you are passing on generational trauma. Don't do that. So I just wanted to create a story which real audience, real young people can kind of relate to. And for that, I needed to kind of look into my own experiences and the experiences of people around me. And I mean, again, as I keep saying, the story would not have been possible without my closest, idiotic, amazing friends, Akshat, Priya, Malshri, Suradha, Shweta, Soumya, all of them. They were the ones who read the first draft. And they were like, nahi Sula, ye dialogue nahi work kar raha yaar, isko change kar. So co-written wale credit mein unka naam aane chahiye the. Because I think I've derived something or the other, be it the abusive relationships, be it the mental health issues, be it, you know, the giddiness when you finally talk to your crush, and that entire innocence of things from all of us around. So it's just having those kind of friends and the safety net of people. You know, sexual orientation apart, like some emotions are so universal, right? So all of them could feel that. The ones who are queer also kind of gave me a little more nuance to things that, no, this might be slightly problematic. Even if you don't mean it in that way, it might come across in that way, and all of that. And obviously my director, Danish, the way he visually represented it, it is beautiful. Like I was in awe. So I hadn't seen the edit. The first time I saw the film was when it released. So because abhi COVID times pe to matlab premiere bhi nahi hua na, hamara kuch bhi nahi hua. Yeah, so I mean, when I saw it, I was like, oh my God, this has come out so beautiful.
Yeah. The edit is brilliant. You know, I felt like I was back on radio again when you were giving like your friends ke naam. They started like shout out, but I'm so glad that you actually did, you know, acknowledge them. And what happens?
Because unke siva unke bina genuinely a show nahi banta. Matlab itne rants sune ya na unhone mere ki bhai, guys, I'm not a good writer, guys. What am I doing, guys? No, I can't do this. And they were like, Sula, shut up. This is a good story. So when they saw the episode, they were like, oh my God, we've been through the entire process. It feels like Muskan and Tarasha are as much our actual friends. So yeah.
So you were in this bid to make this real story, right? Now, the idea was to have as many people as possible connect and relate to it. Now, what happens when they don't? How do you deal with that? Those reviews or those trolls, or not, even if they're not just trolling, just people just saying, ki yaar, you know, I have a friend, she and her girlfriend were so excited to look at it, but she's like, no, I didn't feel it. And then I was doubting myself. I was like, but I have a straight person POV on this, so I'm not sure. Mm-hmm. But how do you take that in your stride?
I think it's difficult for sure, because I am a new writer. I'm just 2 shows old. So there is a lot for me to learn. What my girlfriend very nicely told me before the day before the release, and that stuck to me. She was like, you cannot take it personally. Yes, it's your story, but there's a lot more to filmmaking than just the story. Take every review with a pinch of salt, not just reviews, anything. Like, and today my friend Akshat also told me the same thing, that once the show is out, it is no longer yours. It is, everybody is entitled to their opinion. You take the ones you like, you take positive criticism, and then you go ahead with it. You utilize that in your next thing. Now there's nothing you can do about it. There were 1 or 2 people who were like really mean about it. I'm not going to take names, but like, I was like, ouch, that hurt for like a split second. But the kind of love that even reviewers and everybody is kind of shown to the story, I just feel really, really, really humbled. I never thought this sounds like such a award-taking wala moment. I feel so humbled. But like genuinely, like every morning that I wake up, I'm flooded with DMs saying that we finally feel seen on screen. And I think that's the reason I wrote it in the first place. I wrote it with utmost honesty. That is something I know. Ab uske baad, there will obviously be things. Mera bhi caste or class privilege hai hi. And that's what I was talking to a friend today. And I was like, I know I wrote this story also from a space of comfort, because this is the world I know. The Bombay life is what I know. I mean, there is no, I can't take that away from me. Maybe in the longer run, slowly and gradually, I would want to tell stories that I don't belong to, like the kind of spaces where I don't belong in. But I know for a fact that today, if I was writing a story which wasn't probably based in Bombay, which didn't have the kind of characters that I knew and resonated with, because I haven't traveled as much, I haven't met a lot of kind of people who are from the haven't had the same kind of life experiences as me, which I want to grow as a writer like that. Where, because I remember talking about this to a lot of my friends, and you know, I see Anurag Kashyap, I see Varun Grover, and they have got so much more color to their characters. I want to do that. But then I remind myself that I'm just 25. There is a long way to go. पहली और आखिरी कहानी नहीं बना रही हूँ मैं. धीरे धीरे सीखती जाऊंगी. It's like a lifelong journey. There is no retirement age for writing. I know for a fact that the next story that I write will have something that this story didn't. So I just need people to trust me, or trust the fact that I am trying. और अगर गलती होती है थोड़ी बहुत माफ कर देना. Call me out also if there is major fuck-ups. I deserve that. But अपने तरफ से बस कोशिश जारी रखनी है कि the stuff that I didn't see when I was growing up, the fact that I didn't see myself on screen while growing up, I'm just trying to change that. And I'm trying to enable more people to be able to change that as well.
You spoke about what you didn't see and wanting to show it on screen, but do you see yourself writing straight characters ki stories also?
I am doing 2 of them right now.
Okay.
And they are very good stories. So one is another young adult story itself, and the other one is a thriller. So dono straight hai, but dono achhi tagdi kahani hai. So ye baat aisi hai ki bas kahaniyan likhi jani hai. And I would want to create as much inclusivity as I can. Like the stories that I write, like the commissioned work that I get often, might or might not be queer, but most of the stories that I develop from my end, like right now, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 stories which are queer, which I am developing. So actually 5. Like all the stuff that I create somehow will intrinsically have a queer character. It's not necessarily stories about sexuality, but they are stories that where my protagonists are queer. And a lot of people ask me, ki, bhai, why? Why does this need to happen?
And
I'm just like, if your investigating officer is a straight person, why can't it be a queer person? It has like, just like the character being straight doesn't add or subtract anything from the story. Similarly, her being queer does not add or subtract anything from the story, but it is just her. Why do you just need a queer character when it furthers the plot? Their sexuality is none of your business, but I just want to put it. Tumko kya problem hai?
Queer characters on screen which you felt were wonderfully written or you looked up to and you're like, damn, aise karna hai, aise likhna
hai. I will be the utmost cliche and be like David and Patrick, yaar. Bas wahi chahiye zindagi mein. Matlab, even actually, there's a show on Netflix which I keep talking about. It's called One Day at a Time. And it has this character called Elena, who's again a teenager, who again I see a lot of Muskan in. Like I kind of got inspired from Elena as well because of that awkwardness, the giddiness, the oh my god, is the person I have a crush on gay or not? Like, how do I say that I'm gay without saying gay? So Elena, David and Patrick are like my go-to people the moment it comes to like queer representation. Like they're just so wholesome.
Dan Levy really created some magic there. How much control did you have when it came to jaise story direct ho rahi thi, naam aapne kaise chuna ki Muskan aur Tarasha hoga unka naam? Like, how do you go about that?
So, okay. So, funny story. So Muskan naam, I don't really know. I don't exactly remember where I got that name from. But there is one Tarasha that I know of. Okay. I think at least Bombay circuit mein, puri Bombay, I think ek hi Tarasha ko jaanti hai. Haan, matlab ye naam utna, sorry. Ye naam utna common to hai nahi. But I remember reading, hearing this name somewhere through a few friends. And I was like, there is something about this name. It is not your Shania as well, but it's real, but also kind of funky. So I just like somewhere thought that this kind of a character is like Tarasha. But Muskan, okay, funny story. Muskan's character is pretty much inspired by somebody that meant a lot to me last year during the lockdown. And we are not in touch anymore, but that is her. Like I wanted like the introversion, the sense of humor, the stupid puns of like serial killer wala jo pun tha, fair curly hair, everything is just has always been her. So that is where Muskan came from.
But were you able to influence the casting choice?
Not really. But characters mein maine dala tha ki how what kind of a person Muskan is and what kind of a person Tarasha is. Jaise Muskan ke character sketch mein tha ki he's somebody who will know what sari Sushmita Sen wore in every song of Main Ho Na. So she's that kind of a person. So aisa karke, so I made at least mera vision clear and then Danish did the stuff perfectly.
Anjita Bhattacharya, by the way, and Saba Azad, those are their names, and both of them are so good individually and together, and their equation, everything is on point. So that was fantastic. Last note, and I know this is something that has been doing the rounds that everyone wants to see more of, for writers to be given credit in the trailers when it comes out, your closing remarks on that.
Please de do yaar. Guys, producers, directors, jo bhi sun rahe ho, please. Bahut mehnat karte hai hum log. Thodi izzat de do, thoda naam de do. सारे राइटर्स को डायरेक्टर्स बनना पड़ेगा, तो ऐसा मत करवाओ, हमको लिखने दो, हमको थोड़ा सा प्यार दे दो, because it's that is all that we really look forward to, that just acknowledge us, we are not asking for more, just give us the credit that we deserve, because everybody knows that without a good story, the rest can't, like, you can have the best cinematography, you can have the best other everything, but if the story doesn't land, it just doesn't land. So just give us bare minimum love, bare minimum attention, and watch us make the world a better, brighter place. Make us feel bitter, then, well, people with your character, with people with your name will be killed off in the next stories that we write, or like horrible things will be done to them.
Now that is a legit threat. And honestly, that, I don't know what is worse, having a bad film with a bad story or this threat, because if you don't credit, then you're just going to get lines like, my business is my business, none of your business. Aapko aise lines chahiye? नहीं ना give writers their due. They're only asking for their due. Okay. And when you show that love to the writers, also please show this video some love and spread the good word. Let more people watch this. It's out on Netflix. It feels like Ishq. And we're talking about the fourth wala episode, the fourth short story.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sulagna. Lots of love and prayers to your mom. And we can't wait to see what you do Thank next. You. I only wish for lots of interviews, red carpets, and premieres, which are totally due. All of that needs to happen.
COVID, please go. Corona, go, please.